Welcome to my YouTube channel, and thank you for your interest in building codes and zoning codes and ADA, which is not a code, it's an act. It's the Americans with Disabilities Act. So we're going to look at how these three apply to a specific project that landed on my desk. So the client says they got a design from a designer. They believe this design is just missing details and needs to be permitted. I'm gonna double check. I'm gonna verify against the big three. Bling. The program is an adult daycare center, and let's take a look. This is all existing. It's an existing building. There's also a lobby here and another unit off here, which is not drawn. So we currently really only have two exits from the space. One, two. And the designer has proposed this exit with this ramp that leads down to the ground level outside. Now, according to ADA section 206.4.1, at least 60% of public entrances must be accessible in new construction. This is not new construction, but jurisdictionally, locally, 20% of the building budget must go towards making things ADA accessible. So this needs to be considered. This exit that the designer put in is necessary because without this, think about it. We have one, two exits from the space, and this one comes out to stairs. So this only has 50% of the exits as accessible. So we need a third one, and we need to have two of them accessible, which would give us 66.666 repeating percent accessible, more than 60. It's gotta be at least 60%. So this is required. Now, I'm getting ahead of myself. We gotta look at the zoning code. Let's go to ZMIS to check the zoning code. Put in the address, which I'm not going to disclose. I respect my client's privacy, thank you very much. So zoning is QC2. C2 allows for adult daycare. So there's also a Q in front, which means there's a Q condition, which means there is an overlay ordinance, but I checked and thankfully that also allows for adult daycare. So we're in the clear so far. You know what? I think it's time to look at the building code because I think that's the one that might throw a wrench in the wheel with this design here. So I'm gonna quickly draw what's existing. Since it's sprinklered, we probably will be able to have about a 200 foot travel distance to the exit, so we should be fine at any point. But if we were having to comply with the 75 foot travel distance, at any point from here, we'd be in trouble. We'd have to add another exit here, but I don't think we're gonna be required to do that. I'm gonna look at that later. You know what we gotta check? The plumbing fixtures, because I don't know if this is going to fly for this whole space. IBC, where you at? Now, what I have here is a copy of the International Building Code. There is the 2020 California Building Code, which is based on the International Building Code. And usually it's more stringent than this, from what I've heard. So I'm gonna have to cross-check that. So per chapter 10 for daycare, we get 35 net square feet per occupant. So that's how we get our occupant load. So the space is 5,700 square feet divided by 35. We have 163 occupants. Always round up when doing this. Now chapter 29 tells us we need one water closet per 15 occupants for males, one water closet per 15 occupants for females, and one lavatory per 15 occupants for males and one lavatory for 15 occupants per females. We need one shower or bathtub for the space. And we need one drinking fountain per 100 occupants. I don't think the design that was put in front of me satisfies. Let's take a look. So we've got our 163 occupants divided by two. So 82 men, 82 women. So 5.4, we got to round that up to six. So six sinks. Six. The restroom area has just got a hell of a lot bigger. So only up to 50% of the water closets in the men's room can be urinals. The rest have to be toilets. So we've got three of each. So we're also adding a unisex toilet here. So I guess we're doing all the plumbing in red. Perfect. We're also required a shower, which this doesn't have, so we're going to add one here. We're going to need two drinking fountains. I'm going to make those accessible from the space here. And the janitor's closet is also going to need a sink. There we have it. It is feasible. Some things have to change. A lot more plumbing than they had originally hoped. But it is what it is. So this is probably would take about 3 to 4 months of like back and forth with the city and getting corrections and getting the change of use and everything, because this was not the use before. Thank you for watching. You made it this far. You might as well subscribe, hit the like button, leave a comment. Check out some other content here. I'll probably put like the architect's mixtape and maybe building system wraps or like my design process or something, or Archicast. You guys should check all those out. Stuff on my channel. Check out my Instagram. Hit me up. Get at me. Seriously. I live for this stuff. I love this stuff. So I'm up for chatting about it anytime. Peace and love.